Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for gathering us today again. Thank you, God, because this is such a great opportunity we have in you. We thank you, Father, because you think about us, you plan for us, you everything that concerns us, oh Lord, is always on your mind. And we thank you, God. We thank you that, Lord, every time that we need anything, you have already thought about it. You've already supplied all our needs. You have already planned our future. And so we can walk with boldness, knowing that, God, you have already taken care of everything for us. And so even this morning, we thank you that you've already prepared a table for us, oh God, and you just ask us to come and partake of it, and that, God, that we should walk in the fullness of what Christ truly died for. So we thank you this morning, and we honor you, we welcome you on this platform, and we thank you for your presence with us all day today. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. You're welcome to the presence of the Lord this morning. Now we will go into our moment of praise and worship.
I have a maker. He formed my heart before even time. My life was in his hand. He knows my name. He knows my every thought. And he sees each tear that falls. And hears me when I call. Let's all sing, I have a Father.
Thank you.
Amen. Amen. We were created just to worship the Lord. And so we thank God for that moment of worship. And now we will go into our general prayers. This morning, our general prayers will be led by George Matthew. You're welcome, George Matthew.
Pastor Jesus, please go ahead. I don't think it's on.
Amen. We thank God so much for this morning. We give him all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise this morning. Our first prayer this morning is, Father, thank you for today. Thank you for sending Jesus Christ to die for us and shedding the blood of Jesus Christ on the earth for our salvation and victory. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we thank you this morning. We give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise, O God. Father, thank you for sending Jesus Christ to die for us and shedding the blood of Jesus Christ on the earth for our salvation and victory. Lord, we give you praise. We give you honor and adoration. We thank you. We worship you. We honor you. We adore you, O God. Thank you because, Father, you are an excellent God. Thank you, Lord, O God, for sending Jesus Christ to die for us and shedding the blood of Jesus Christ on the earth for our salvation and victory. We give you all the praise, honor, and adoration. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen. Our prayer number two says, Father, thank you for the blood of Jesus, which is ever present with us and heals all our sicknesses and diseases and grant our deliverance and enlargement and destroy every enemy and opposition to our success and triumph. Let us pray. Once again, Father, this morning we thank you, O God. We thank you for sending your son, Jesus Christ, to come and die for us, O God. And we thank you for the blood of Jesus Christ, which is ever present with us and which heals all our sicknesses and diseases and grants our deliverance and enlargement and destroy every enemy and opposition to our success and triumph. O Lord, this morning we bless and we worship you. We thank you, O Lord Jesus Christ, for dying on the cross of Calvary and shedding your blood for us, O God, which is ever present with us, O God, which is ever powerful with us, O God. The blood that heals our diseases and our sicknesses, the blood that grants our deliverance and our enlightenment, the blood of Jesus Christ that destroys every enemy and opposition to our success and triumph. Father, we thank you and we bless you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Amen. Our prayer number three, we said, Father, by the blood of Jesus Christ, I declare total cleansing, healing, and deliverance for me and my household, and by it, the destruction of the works of evil in my family. Let us pray. Oh, Lord Jehovah, Father, once again, oh God, I declare in the name of Jesus Christ, by the blood of Jesus Christ, I declare total cleansing and healing and deliverance for me and my household, and by it, the destruction of the works of evil in my family. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I said, Father, rise up on my behalf, O God. Jehovah, by the blood of Jesus Christ, today I declare total healing, O God, total cleansing, O God. I declare total deliverance for me and my household, me and my family, me and my descendants, O God, me and my extended family. And I said, Father, by the blood of Jesus, we destroy, we declare the destruction of the works of evil in my family. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we say, Father, today, O God, I baptize my family in the blood of Jesus Christ. I soak my family in the blood of Jesus Christ. I declare the blood of Jesus Christ covers my whole family, O God, my whole household, O God, bringing cleansing and healing and deliverance to me and my household, and by it, the destruction of the works of evil in my family. In the name of Jesus Christ, thank you, Father, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Now our prayer number 4. We said, Father, in Jesus' name, I baptize my city and its inhabitants. Mention your city by name. In the blood of Jesus and by it, let every satanic habitation and demonic altars in my city be destroyed in Jesus' name. Let us pray. Father, in Jesus' name, I baptize my city, Beaverton, Oregon, and its inhabitants in the blood of Jesus Christ. And by it, let every satanic habitation and demonic altars in my city, Beaverton, Oregon, be destroyed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh, Father, now we declare in Jesus' name, Father, I baptize my city, oh God, Beaverton, Oregon, and its inhabitants in the blood of Jesus Christ, oh Lord. And by it, oh God, Lord, let every satanic habitation and demonic altars in my city be destroyed in the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen. Our prayer number 5. We said, now, plead the blood of Jesus over your city. Please mention your city by name. And for cleansing and sanctification, that will bring the revival of salvation by the blood of Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Now, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I plead the blood of Jesus Christ over my city, Beaverton, Oregon, O God, for cleansing and sanctification, that will bring the revival of salvation by the blood of Jesus Christ, O God. O Lord, this morning, in the name of Jesus Christ, Father, I plead the blood of Jesus Christ, the ever powerful blood of Jesus Christ, over my city, Beaverton, Oregon, O God, for cleansing and sanctification that will bring the revival of salvation by the blood of Jesus Christ. Now, Father, I plead the blood of Jesus Christ over my city, Marysville, Washington, O God, for cleansing and sanctification that will bring the revival of salvation by the blood of Jesus Christ, we pray. Thank you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Amen. Now our prayer number 6. Mr. Father, in Jesus' name and by the blood of Jesus Christ, let there be an outbreak of mighty manifestations of your power and miracles in my city. Please mention your city by name, thereby bringing about a wave of salvation of souls in my city. Let us pray. Oh Lord, once again, in the name of Jesus Christ, by the blood of Jesus, let there be an outbreak of mighty manifestations of your power and miracles in my city, Beaverton, Oregon, and Washington, O God, thereby bringing about a wave of salvation of souls in my city, O God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, we soak, O God, the cities in the blood of Jesus Christ. We soak the land, O God, the atmosphere, O God. We soak everywhere with the blood of Jesus Christ, that no demonic altar would be able to exist in our cities, O God, in the name of Jesus Christ. We say, Father, in Jesus' name, and by the blood of Jesus Christ, let there be an outbreak of mighty manifestations of your power, the power of Jesus Christ and the power of God, and miracles in my city, Beaverton, Oregon, and Marysville, Washington, God, by thereby bringing about a wave of salvation of souls in my city. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen. Now our final prayer. We say, Father, I declare as I take the communion by the blood of Jesus, let your mighty power of healing and deliverance flow through my body. Now let us pray. Oh, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I declare, oh God, as I take the communion, the Last Supper, the body of Jesus Christ and the blood of Jesus Christ, let your mighty power by the blood of Jesus Christ, let your mighty power of healing and deliverance flow through my body and flow through every area of my life, oh God. Saturate my life with the power of the blood of Jesus Christ, bringing healings and deliverances and enlargements and victory. Every blessing, every victory of Jesus Christ on the cross of Calvary, Father, I proclaim it in my life, oh God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, by the stripes of Jesus Christ, we are healed. He says he took our infirmities upon upon himself. He took all our sickness upon himself. Said as Jesus Christ was crucified, yes, he said, you know, he walked into hell and snatched the keys of life and death from Satan. Father, as I take the communion of God, I partake in the victory, the power and the victory of the blood of Jesus Christ and the victory of Jesus Christ on the cross of Calvary. Oh, manifested in healings and deliverance of God and enlightenments and breakthroughs of God and turnarounds in my life and the life of everyone on this platform this morning. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we said, Father, by the blood of Jesus Christ, Lord, we declare a Passover over our homes of God. Now, no demon will be able to come near our families of God, that the evil happening in the world shall not come to our families of God as we take the communion of God. Father, let the power of the Passover come upon us of God and our homes of God. Let there be healings and deliverances now flowing through our bodies of God. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen. And we are saying that, you know, after the morning devotion, please get your communion. You can take, you know, your juice and your little cracker and take the communion in your house. Amen. We thank God so much for answered prayers in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, God. Thank you so much, Pastor Jesus, for leading us in those prayers. And now we will go into our Bible reading. This morning's Bible reading is taken from Joshua 24, verse 11 to 28. Joshua 24, verse 11 to 28. And our sister Claire will read to us.
Well, good morning, family. I'm going to be reading from the New International Version. Joshua 24, 11 to 28. Then you crossed the Jordan and came to Jericho. The citizens of Jericho fought against you, as did also the Amorites, Perizzites, Canaanites, Hittites, Girgashites, Hivites, and Jebusites. But I gave them into your hands. I sent the hornet ahead of you, which drove them out before you, also the two Amorite kings. You did not do it with your own sword and bow. So I gave you a land on which you did not toil and cities you did not build. And you live in them and eat from the vineyards and olive groves that you did not plant. Now fear the Lord and serve him with all faithfulness. Throw away the gods your ancestors worshipped before the Euphrates River and in Egypt and serve the Lord. But if serving the Lord seems undesirable to you, then choose for yourselves this day whom you will serve, whether the gods your ancestors served before the Euphrates or the gods of the Amorites in whose land you are living. But as for me and my household, we will serve the Lord. Then the people answered, far be it from us for us to forsake the Lord to serve other gods. It was the Lord our God himself who brought us and our parents up out of Egypt from that land of slavery and performed those great signs before our eyes. He protected us on our entire journey and among all the nations through which we traveled. And the Lord drove out before us all the nations, including the Amorites who lived in the land. We too will serve our Lord because he is our God. Joshua said to the people, you are not able to serve the Lord. He is a holy God. He is a jealous God. He will not forgive your rebellion and your sins. If you forsake the Lord and serve foreign gods, he will turn and bring disaster on you and make an end of you after he has been good to you. But the people said to Joshua, no, we will serve the Lord. Then Joshua said, you are witnesses against yourselves that you have chosen to serve the Lord. Yes, we are witnesses, they replied. Now then, said Joshua, throw away the foreign gods that are among you and yield your hearts to the Lord, the God of Israel. And the people said to Joshua, we will serve the Lord our God and obey him. On that day, Joshua made a covenant for the people, and there at Shechem, he reaffirmed for them decrees and laws. And Joshua recorded these things in the book of the law of God. Then he took a large stone and set it up there under the oak near the holy place of the Lord. See, he said to all the people, this stone will be a witness against us. It has heard all the words the Lord has said to us. It will be a witness against you if you are untrue to your God. Then Joshua dismissed the people, each to their own inheritance. The word of God for the people of God.
Amen. Thank you for that reading of the word. And now we are ready for the charge. Today, our charge will be brought to us by our sister Kehinde. You're welcome, sister Kehinde.
Good morning, God's people. Good morning, Pastor Tunji. I want to thank you, sir, for the opportunity of doing another charge this morning. I am really grateful. What is the meaning? My title today is Commitment to Kingdom Service. What is the meaning of commitment to kingdom service? This simply means giving your life, time, energy, and resources to serve God and his kingdom. It is to serve the God's need and ensure that his work on earth does not suffer loss. In Matthew 6:33, Jesus teaches us to first seek the kingdom of heaven. And in John 4:34, he also said, "My meat is to do the will of him that sent me and to finish his work." Example of Jesus's commitment to kingdom service can be seen in Matthew 20. The way that God had sent Jesus on earth to do its work in his vineyard, he also sent us to work to do his work. Our life belongs to God, and it does not belong to us. Our talent, strength, and resources do not belong to us either. They belong to God for the service of his kingdom. The service of Jesus Christ's kingdom service is worthy of emulating. He refers to the service of the kingdom as a meat. He derived great pleasure and sweetness from kingdom service rather than attaching pain to it. These days, a lot of us prefer the meat, the physical meat and pleasure to kingdom assignment. Jesus said he would finish what he was sent to do. And this was why he said, "It is finished," at the cross of Calvary. We must also strive to complete and finish God's assignment for our lives. In order for this, we must be hardworking and very zealous. In John 9:4, Jesus said, "I must work the work of him that sent me while it is day. The night cometh when no man can work." Jesus saw that the work of God as a must and not a wish, something that has to be finished. That has to be done. We can learn from this verse that the time to be zealous is now, and the time may come when it will be too late to do anything for God. Jesus said this about commitment to service. "No servant can serve two masters, for he will either hate one and love the other, or he will be devoted to one and despise the other. We cannot serve God and money." We can also see a similar commitment to kingdom service in the life of Joshua when we read the Old Testament. Joshua's commitment to God's kingdom service was complete obedience. His concern was to do precisely as he was instructed. The promise of the Lord will be fulfilled. The instruction might seem strange, but his faith in the outcome urged him on. After the death of Moses, God called Joshua to lead the Israelites across the Jordan River and to take possession of the promised land. His response to God's call to service was, "Whatever you have commanded us, we will do. Wherever you send us, we will go." Not even Moses exemplified the total commitment to kingdom service as Joshua in terms of his obedience, his faithfulness, his dependability, his trustworthiness, commitment, and dedication as recorded in the Bible. Moses was sent by God to lead children of Israel to the promised land. However, He was unable to fulfill God's promise purpose for his life because he did not believe God. You can see this in Numbers 20:12, and I quote, "But the Lord said to Moses and Aaron, because you did not trust in me enough to honor me as holy in sight of the Israelites, you will not bring the community into the land I give them." In the New Testament, one who also exemplified total commitment to kingdom service was Apostle Paul, but time will not allow me to elaborate on his character and his commitment. However, the following verses would help. Galatians 2:20, Philippians 3:8, Romans 3:36 to 39, 2 Corinthians 11:22 to 31. When you serve God well, your head will never lack anointing. And if the anointing is not lacking, the yoke must break. Kingdom service would allow us to experience God's presence, his power, and his blessing. Because God said, he has not called us to serve him in vain. Hebrews 11:6, and is a faithful rewarder of those who diligently serve him. Isaiah 15:19. We should be willing and ready to carry the cross even as Jesus Christ paid on the cross for our salvation and our redemption. All the apostles also paid similar price by matador for the sake of the gospel and kingdom service. We, the saints, are not exempt. Let me finally conclude by citing the words of Apostle Paul in 2 Timothy 4:7-8. "I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. Now there is in store for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, would award to me on the day, and not only to me, but also to all who long for its appearing. Are you willing to fight the fight? Are you willing to finish the race? Will you continue in faith? Because there is a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous God, judge, would allow to you and me on the last day when he appears. I pray that we all be wearing the crown of righteousness on that day in the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you for the charge of today. We know your blessing and protection is upon us. Thank you for affording me the opportunity to do this. I'm really grateful and I appreciate you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, everybody.
We thank God so much for that wonderful time. Thank you, Sister Kehinde, for bringing the word of God expressly. And as we have heard this week, talking about kingdom commitment, if we could just take those words and find that language and find it in our hearts to actually truly give that commitment to God 100% and see the things that we need to put aside and see the things that we need to take on in learning the word of God so that we can truly be committed. So as we go into our personal time of prayer, among all the things that you have come this morning to request from the Lord, also go ahead and give your full commitment to him also in prayer. And we will go into prayer time and then we'll return back shortly. Thank God so much for that wonderful time in prayer this morning. And we thank God for the answers that he has already provided for all the prayers that we have made to him individually and corporately on this platform. And so we thank God so much. Today, as you go, may you go with the blessing that Joshua blessed the children of Israel. In Joshua 23, verse 10, he said, one of your men puts to flight 8,000, for the Lord your God is he who fights for you just as he promised you. So today, as you take delight in serving him, as you take delight in following him and committing to him 100%, doing those things that God has asked you to do, seeking the Lord diligently just to be committed to the kingdom of God and to all that he has assigned you to do, in your business, in your job, in your family, with your children, wherever you go, that you are so equipped for everything that you're going to face today, that as you have started your day with the Lord, he's already provided you your daily bread. He's provided you your daily resources so that everything that you walk into today, whatever comes to you as a surprise today, is not really a surprise to God. He's already gone ahead of you. He's already prepared for you. So once you get through the shock of the initial surprise, the first few seconds when you panic, and then you pray, help me, he's already prepared. He's already prepared a table for you. So the Lord is with you today to bless you, to honor you, to give you victory, because when he gives you that victory, it is his victory. It reflects well on his kingdom. And it causes men to see the good things that God is doing in your life, and they become drawn to the Father. So we thank God so much for today. Remember, this program runs Monday through Friday. Today is Friday. So as you go into the weekend, take strength in everything that you have learned today. If you get a minute,
have a good day.
Go back to those prayers that you were praying this week that really, really touched you, and pray at them again. I like to go back, especially over the weekend, to the morning devotions that I either missed or the ones that I really, really enjoyed. And I want to restate those statements. We've had a lot of declarations. So go back and declare those things over your life, over your family, and even the messages that have been preached. It's a good time to go back and do that. And the Lord will bless you. And share those messages also with others, even those who cannot join morning devotion. Just send them the links and say, hey, look at this message. See how it touches you, and the Lord will bless you. But as much as you can, invite them also to come. That is a good taste. The Bible says, oh, taste and see the Lord is good. So send them a taste of the morning devotion and let them see what we do so that they can see that that's something that they want to commit to and to come and join us every day. And the Lord will greatly bless you. So thank you so much for coming this morning. And now we're going to share the goodness. Surely God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. God bless you.